So today we are going to discuss about type of flours for bread making and confectionaries and influence of various additives added to the batter or dough to get baked products. The term baking is usually applied to obviously flour based foods for which mostly wheat, oats, maize, and sorghum cereal flours are used. And they have a relatively long shelf life. That is all about baked food products. What is the purpose of baking? It changes eating quality of the staple. It also adds variety to the diet, and it is a means of preservation that is extend shelf life of the baked product compared to freshly prepared product from the same cereal flours. That extension of shelf life is because of removal of moisture and inhibition of various enzymes as well as bacteria. Breads and pastries have a shelf life of 2 to 5 days, whereas biscuits and some cakes have longer shelf life. They may be kept even for several months. Main issue is their packing must be very nice. They should be correctly packed. During baking, food is heated by the hot air in the oven. And during baking, because of that heating treatment, moisture at the surface is evaporated by the heat and a dry crust forms. For biscuit production, comparatively slower heating is required, by which moisture is lost not only from the surface but also from the inside of the product. That's why its shelf life is much, much longer comparatively. Baked goods are produced either from dough or batters, which is a mixture of flour and water, and made by either mixing, beating, kneading, or folding. These are processes of mixing flour with water. Processing method depends upon various ingredients being used and the product being made. For all baking wheat flour and many other ingredients are used, each of which have different effects on the final baked products. Now let us talk about flour. Obviously, flour refers to powder obtained from grinding of a cereal grain. And flours can be obtained from different wheat varieties, which vary in the protein content. Normally, two types of wheat, that is hard wheat and soft wheat, are being used for preparation of baked food products. Hard wheat flour have good bread making quality because they form good loaf volume, and it also contains high protein content, which ranges between 12 to 14%. Hardness is related to degree of adhesion between starch and protein. Hardness and softness refers to the way in which the endosperm breaks down on milling. In hard wheat, fragmentation of endosperm tends to occur along the lines of the cell boundaries, whereas endosperm of soft wheat fractures in a random way. Hard wheat yields coarse and gritty flour, whereas soft wheat give very fine flour, which is suitable for biscuit making. Strength of wheat relates to its baking quality. Hard wheat produces large loaf volume and good crumb structure required for bread making. Hard flour dough is more elastic and more resistant to stretching than soft flour dough. Bread flour should form good gluten when mixed with water, which is responsible for a good volume of bread. Whereas soft wheat flour, which contains lower protein content comparatively, that is lower than 10%. And this is good for biscuits and cakes preparation. Biscuit flour. For the dough, having more extensibility, biscuit flour dough have more extensibility but less resistant than bread dough. They form only a small loaf with coarse crumb structure. Now let us see characteristics of good cake flour. Medium strength flour from soft low protein wheat of low alpha amylase activity and very fine in structure. Purpose of the flour allowed an aerated structure to be retained after the cake has been whisked. Stability of the final cake depends on presence of uniformly swollen starch granules. Hence, starch granules should be undamaged during milling and it should be free from adherent protein and be unattacked by the amylolytic enzymes. For preparation of soft and tender cakes, low protein flour is required, which contains protein between 7 to 9%. Flour must be chlorinated for preparation of higher sugar containing cakes. And good milling is responsible to achieve these characteristics. But most important thing is that wheat must be of appropriate quality. That is, raw material should be good. Characteristics and general quality of flour depends on, obviously, the variety and conditions under which the wheat crop has been grown. It also affects quality as well as quantity of gluten in the grain. Milling processes determines degree of separation of the bran and endosperm and particle size of the flour, which are important factors in the cake flour. Additives and special treatments used for producing flour mixes with special characteristics are very important. We will discuss about different additives. First is yeast, which is used as a leavening agent, and Saccharomyces cerevisiae is the strain used specially for baked products. After addition to dough at pH 4 to 6 and temperature of 30 degrees centigrade, yeast begins to feed on the starch in the mixture and form sugar, alcohol, and ultimately carbon dioxide, which is responsible for expansion of the dough. Dough must be kneaded thoroughly to distribute bubbles evenly and then left to rise again, which is usually resulting in about double of its original volume. But one precaution should be taken that if mixture is left for too long as such, then acid is produced by oxidation of the alcohol, and that is responsible for sour taste of the product, which is undesirable by the consumer. Now let us talk about different chemical leavening agents. Two types of leavening agents are mostly used. Either it is either baking powder or baking soda. Most important chemical agent is baking powder, which is a mixture of sodium bicarbonate and a weak solid acid or acid salt. When mixture dissolves in water and the temperature is raised, there is production of carbon dioxide responsible for increase in the volume. Most common acids used are potassium hydrogen tartrate, tartric acid, acid calcium phosphate. When baking powder is used rather than baking soda alone, byproducts result in less alkaline than sodium carbonate and have no undesirable effects on taste of the product. Type of acid used in the baking powder obviously affects the rate of carbon dioxide production, which affects the product's quality. In baking, rate at which carbon dioxide is produced and continuity of carbon dioxide production, both are important. Baking powder is a very widely used ingredient in cooking and baking. Self-raising flour has also become popular in recent years, which is available in the market. It is merely high-grade flour to which baking soda and a suitable acid such as cream of tartar have already been added, and that can be simply used for preparation of cake or bread. Second leavening agent is baking soda, that is simple sodium bicarbonate, and it is also used as a leavening agent. It has the property of releasing carbon dioxide when it is heated, just shown here in the this reaction. When it is used on its own, only half the available carbon dioxide is released, and sodium bicarbonate produced is strongly alkaline, giving baked product a bitter or soapy taste, and even its color is yellowish, which is not desirable for the baked products. Even during digestion in gastrointestinal tract of such products, sodium carbonate reacts with hydrochloric acid present in the stomach and produces the other half of the available carbon dioxide, which creates uncomfort in the gastrointestinal tract. Sodium bicarbonate is very rarely used on its own, and it must be mixed with some acidic material for better result. To avoid an imbalance between the acidic and basic materials, that is an incorrect pH, baking powder is more commonly used for preparation of baked products. Second additive is fat, which has number of functions in baking. Most important function of fat is that it weakens or shortens a dough by weakening its gluten network, resulting in the baked product being softer, breaking easily, and having a more tender mouthfeel. Fat can trap air during beating and mixing, and batter that consists of masses of tiny air bubbles trapped within droplets of fat result in more expanded baked product, forming a light and airy structure. In puff pastry, fats which are soft over a wide temperature range are used and spread between pastry layers, and will separate them during cooking, giving a layered pastry. Fats should have a bland flavor so that it cannot change the flavor of the finished product. But occasionally, fats are chosen on the basis of their flavor, which is desired in that particular product. For example, butter is used for some of the baked goods and lard for meat pie pastry. Fat is able to form an emulsion with the other ingredients in the batter or dough. Next additive is sugar, which undergoes a series of complex browning reactions when heated above 160 degrees centigrade, and products of these form the brown crust of many baked goods. These reactions involve amino acid catalyzed caramelization reactions, in which a sugar aldehyde or ketone is converted to unsaturated aldehyde or ketone. Even sugar at the very low level, that is between 0.5 to 0.75%, increases rate of fermentation for fermented goods, for example, specifically for bread, by giving yeast more sugar to work on. Large quantities of sugar can be added to non-fermented goods, for example, biscuits, in order to improve the keeping quality of the biscuits as well as increase its sweetness. Next is ascorbic acid. Its addition, even in very small amount, that is between cross-linking reactions, to form a more extensible, elastic, strong network. Next additive is egg. It is also an important ingredient which is added in wide variety of bakery products. It is used to improve physical and organoleptic properties of products. Beaten egg white gives the dough a light, airy texture. It can be used as emulsifiers, moisteners, and a source of fat and all the essential amino acids. This also improves cell structure of the product and maintain it during baking process and reduce the moisture loss from the baked product. Next is salt. It is added to enhance flavor of the cakes and breads. This also toughens up the soft mixture of fat and sugar. Salt has retarding effect on yeast fermentation. In its absence, fermentation takes place very rapidly and the dough is too sticky to knead properly, resulting in the coarse texture of the baked bread. That is all about type of flour and addition of different additives. Thank you. Thank you very much.